It's another day's journey, and I'm glad.
I'm glad about it.
Oh, so glad.
I'm glad about it.
So glad.
I'm glad about it.
It's another day's journey, and I'm glad.
I'm glad about it.
Trouble in my way.
Trouble in my way.
I shine sometimes. compassionate friend. And if I would ask him, he will deliver. And make all my troubles come quickly to an end. And I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear these burdens alone, and I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus. Well, Jesus can't help me. Jesus alone, and I must tell Jesus. I must tell Jesus. I cannot bear these burdens alone, and I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus. Well, Jesus can't help me. Jesus
Smith, who is in nursing home, looking better. I'm not sure what the status is, but it looks rested. Because he is in nursing home, so I can pretty much do. Yeah. See the deacons and then all of you who are here, and then of course our friend from all we've been in Annapolis, Professor our sister Max Goddard. Good to see you today, young lady.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I want to hold you long. Look at Psalm 121. Psalm 121 verses 1 and 2. And by the way, there are directions to Macedonia on the table and on the vestibule right to the far left. And basically just go straight up 35. And when you get to the overpass, just keep going straight. And you turn right on Macedonia. You can't miss it. Yeah, the van's going in. And cars, whatever we got. Motorcycle, moped, scooters, skateboards, bicycles, everything. All right, Psalm 121 says, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven. I'm going to talk about where to look when you need help. Where to look when you need help. There are days, at least in my life, when it seems like nothing is going right. There are those who can testify. But you wake up with a migraine or a sinus headache. You look for the shoes that you want to wear that day, and one of them is nowhere to be found. Rush out the door, bump your leg on the coffee table, on your way out the door. Go out to your car, the car won't stop. Finally get to work, and all of your co-workers and others that you serve with have seemed to have lost their minds.
Yes, sir.
All right. It looked like from the time you leave to the time you get off, life appears to have just unraveled. It's one of those days. Then coupled with that are the stresses that come along with being a parent or a spouse. Right? Schedule seems to always be overcrowded. There's always something to do. I never shall forget when Jocelyn was a double X. We had to get up 5 or 6 o'clock to take her to the morning practice. Go 5 or 6 o'clock in the evening practice. It was 2 days they were having preparing for state fair. And she told me, she said, well, you should have had me before Jack and not have my license by now. Dad said, I ain't having that. But then you take all that pressure that comes with being a Christian, with this unending spotlight that you seem to be under. There's this never-ending eye that watches everything you do.
My Lord.
People are disappointed with you, and you're disappointed with yourself. You can never seem to financially make ends meet. Emotionally, you take one step forward, but 3 steps back. Spiritually, you can't find time or won't find time to read the Bible. Can't find time to pray because your life is so crowded with a continuous onslaught of ceaseless activity. And then to make matters worse, you start it all over again the next day.
Yeah.
It doesn't get any better with you. Doesn't get any better with church experience. It doesn't get any better with life, because those of us who have lived for some time have come to realize if it ain't one thing, you just can't seem to get it all done. You can never seem to get it all accomplished. Your life is spiraling out of control. So where do you go for some rest? Where do you go for strength? Where do you go to refuel? Where do you go to get your bearings straight? Where do you go to find some perspective on life? This song of degrees or ascents gives us insight.
Wow.
The musician says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. So first of all, for the believer, there is this look of longing. Because really the writer is asking a question. In other words, he's saying, where does my help come from?
Wow.
We long for things to make sense to us. We long for things to come together. But once we reach a certain age, those things really don't matter as much. Young people, some of the things that you have to look forward to are bills, jobs, bosses, not enough paydays, more bills, your eyes going bad, high blood pressure, and the list goes on. You used to eat whatever you wanted to eat, but those days are gone. You used to be able to think and put whatever you wanted to in your mind. If you wanted to remember something, you should just put it in your mind. But now you got to write it down. And then you forget what you wrote. Then you remember what you wrote it on, but then you forgot where you put it. Some of us are taking so much medicine that you have one of those daily distributors. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. That's just the way it is. And it's not going to get any better. But we look back, wanting and desiring the simpler times. We desire to have a more uncomplicated life. But life is a what's called forced march. Life requires that we move ahead. The moment we come from our mother's womb, we're forced to live life, most often on life's terms.
Yes, sir.
Well, things don't always work out the way we plan. Our plans sometimes go another way. And so the sensitive believer sometimes has to drop his hands or her hand and say, I'll lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? Who can I depend on to bring me through? Who is it that knows what my dilemma is? Where can I get some sort of relief? We really can't look to the doctors and lawyers for help. We can't look to President Obama or Congress for our help. Because their help is shaded by partisan politics. Their help is influenced by voters. And their help, in many cases, especially with Congress, is motivated by deception. They'll acknowledge the plight of our community. They'll say they have a better plan than their opponent does. And then they get in office and get amnesia. Because their help goes to those who donated to their campaign. And their help goes to those who they owe favors to. You go to the backroom deals they made before they got in office. They said now that Donald Trump is using campaign funds to pay his bills. And he's telling people he's using his own money. That's a lie. It doesn't matter what Trump says he's going to do. It doesn't matter what Hillary says she's going to do. We need to understand that if we're going to get any real help, it has to come from the Lord.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, all right.
Don't put your confidence in man, because he may disappoint you.
Yes, sir.
Don't put your confidence in your job, because it may end next year.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Don't put your confidence in your retirement, because you may not live long enough to retire. All of my help come from the Lord.
Uh-huh.
You gotta watch what you're focusing on.
Uh-huh.
Because if you look at your problem too long, you look at the difficulty too long, and you take your eyes off the solution.
Uh-huh.
You remember when David got ready to fight Goliath?
Uh-huh.
He went to the Valley of Gath, otherwise known as the Valley of the Giants.
Yeah.
And Goliath said, "Who is this boy that you send to fight me? Am I a dog that you send this boy to fight me with sticks?" And David said, "Who is this uncircumcised Philistine who dares to insult the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob?" Goliath said, "Boy, take your little body and break it in half and throw it in the air for the birds to feed." And David said, "I'm going to cut your head off so that everybody will know that there's a God in Israel."
Yeah.
I mean, look at what's going on in the Valley of Gath. David appears and seems to be on the losing end.
Wow.
Yes.
But then things are not always what they seem. Goliath is too big for David to hit.
Wow.
But he's also too big for God to miss.
Well.
And if you stop crying about your problem and start praising God about your solution,
yes, sir,
things don't always look like what they seem.
Yes, sir.
Well, when you look to God for your help, not your neighbor, not your co-workers, not your fellow church members, because you discover that the people will be with you as long as it's not too difficult.
Yeah.
As long as it's not too complicated. And as long as they can detach from it whenever they get ready.
Yeah, yeah.
Because really, some of us, to some extent, have all of our own problems.
Wow.
But not so with God. His line is never busy. Don't we sing that song, "Jesus is on the main line"?
Yes, yeah.
Tell him what you want.
Yeah.
People say his number is never busy.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Tell him what you want. He won't put you on hold. He'll never get an answering service to cover his call. But all of our help when we call him comes from the Lord.
Uh-huh.
But now also in the text we see a question of weakness. Because it says, "Where does my help come from?"
Yeah.
And since I can't help myself, it's got to come from somewhere else.
All right.
And as a people, we have become masters of masking needs.
Yeah. Yeah.
We don't want nobody to know we broke.
Yeah.
And all of us are broke.
Yeah.
We don't want nobody to know that we're in pain.
Yes, sir.
We don't want nobody to know that we're about to cry.
Yeah.
If the service gets too emotional, we'll get up and walk out.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because we don't want anybody to know that we're on the verge of tears.
Well,
but we need to understand that life has a way of pushing you from time to time to the verge of tears.
Yeah.
We've got to understand if we keep on living, we will discover that time is filled with swift transitions. Some days are better than others. But most days we're laughing to keep from crying.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And there's somebody here today that if you be honest, you would declare that you were so distraught and you were so broken that you couldn't even articulate how bad off you've been.
Yeah.
Your spirit is so heavy that when you pray, no words come out. Your soul is so troubled that you can't seem to find the Lord. No matter where you look, you find yourself wanting to give up. You find yourself wanting help. But then you discover you've got some help. You've got to say to yourself, "I almost gave up. I was right on the verge of a breakthrough and couldn't see it." The devil really had me. But Jesus came and grabbed and held me close. So I wouldn't let go. God's mercy kept me. So I wouldn't let go. Then you discover that your help comes from the Lord.
Well,
sometimes in our lives, God is deadly silent.
Yeah.
I could handle my troubles if God would just say something.
Yes, sir.
I could bear any burden or any affliction if I knew how it was going to turn out. If God would just tell me the reason, I think I'd be okay. If he would just tell me in advance, I think I could endure the suffering. But I'm forced to say, Father, I stretch my hands to thee. No other help, I don't know.
Yeah.
Have you been there? Have you ever been so sick at night?
Wow.
And looked like morning would never come?
Wow.
I've been there.
Yes, sir.
Have you ever been in a room full of people and yet felt so awful?
Yes, sir.
Have you ever sinned and felt so guilty that you couldn't seem to come out from that dark cloud?
Yeah.
You got to say, Father, I'll stretch my hand to thee.
Yes, sir.
Where does my help come from?
Where?
I've been to the doctor. But the medicine hadn't done me any good. I've been to the psychiatrist's office. I've done the therapy, but none of that has done my soul any good.
Well,
I've got some friends like Job's friend. They cry with me a while. Then they get tired of me and they start talking about me behind my back. Why do the heathen rage? And the people, wicked, imagine a vain thing. Don't let your so-called friends make you feel guilty when you don't know which way to turn.
Well,
because when you get there, you're in good biblical company. Abraham got there.
Yeah.
When Abraham was getting ready to leave Sodom and Gomorrah, the Lord was getting ready to destroy it. And Abraham said, will you destroy the righteous with the wicked? Yeah. Moses got there. He said, Lord, why did you bring these people out to kill them? Your enemies are going to laugh at you. Elijah got there. He said, I worshiped you. And I'm the only one left. I've been on Mount Carmel. I'm the only one, Lord. Take my life.
All right.
Job got there. Job said, I wish I could just find him. I'd rise and take my case before him.
Yeah.
Jesus got there at Calvary. When he says, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Yes, sir.
And there's somebody here today. You've done the best you can.
Yes, sir.
And giving your all in service to Jesus.
Yeah.
It seems like every time you try, you just can't push through. Paul tells us in Philippians, I've learned in whatever state I am.
Yes, sir.
But I'm just going to have to learn to be. But since I'm in this situation, God knows about it. And God won't let anything happen to me that takes him by surprise. So I lift up my eyes unto the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord. Then he says, who made the heaven and earth? And here's how watchful of me he is. He that keepeth me shall never neither sleep nor slumber.
Yes, sir.
The Lord is our keeper. The Lord is the shade on your right hand.
Yes.
The sun won't bother you by day. The moon won't bother you by night. The Lord shall preserve your soul, and he will preserve you from all evil. He'll preserve your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. He said, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. And so that's why we got to go back to verse 2 to finally see our assurance of faith.
Yes, sir.
My help, as we said earlier, doesn't come from Congress. My help doesn't come from a legislative body.
Well,
and as a people, we've been too dependent on politicians who have really just picked us for our homes. My help doesn't come from the benevolent committee in my life. My help comes from the Lord. There may be times when I call on those close to me and they're not available. There may be times I want to confide in my fellow church members. But before Sunday comes, my business is all over the Sunday school. That's why my help has to come from the Lord. He made the heaven and the earth. Now, if he's able to make heaven and earth, surely he's able to see what's going on in my life. Just like he made the heavens and the earth, he made me.
Yes, sir.
And he knows what my needs are.
Yes, sir.
He knows who my enemies are.
Oh, yeah.
He knows those who are plotting against me. And he knows what evil is trying to come against me in my life.
Yeah.
That's why the psalmist will say, fret not thyself because of evil doers.
Yeah.
Be not envious of those workers of iniquity.
Yeah.
They shall soon be cut off like the grass and wither like the green herb. I waited patiently for the Lord, and he inclined his ear unto me. He took my feet out of the miry clay and set them on a solid rock. He established my going. He put a new song in my mouth, even praises unto our God. And once the Lord comes through, you can sing another song. Make a joyful noise. All ye lands, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us and not we ourselves. We are the sheep of his pasture.
Yes, sir.
Enter into his gates with thanksgiving.
Yes.
And into his courts with praise.
Uh-huh.
Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good.
Yes.
His mercy is everlasting.
Yes.
And his truth endureth to all generations.
Yes.
Is there anybody here who's had some down days?
Yes.
Is there anybody here who's had to cry in the midnight hour?
Yes, sir.
Is there anybody here who didn't know which way to turn?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
But the Lord came through and made a way out of nowhere.
Yes,
he made a way.
Yes.
He made a way.
Yes,
one of my favorite stories and personalities in the Old Testament is about a man by the name of Benaiah. He was the son of Jehoiada, a mighty man of valor. And the Bible said that he met a lion in a pit on a snowy day. He met a lion in a pit on a snowy day. And sometimes you and I will meet a lion in a pit on a snowy day. But I tell you what he'll do. Just build your hopes on things eternal. And hold on to God's unchangeable
word.
Hold on, for help is on the way. God will give you the victory. Well, over 2,000 years ago, man needed help. Adam had eaten the forbidden fruit. And it looked like we were in a helpless situation. Abraham failed the truth test. His grandson Jacob had failed the truth test. Moses failed the truth, the mercy test. David failed the fidelity test. Jeremiah cried too much. Ezekiel didn't know nothing. Hosea was too busy trying to find where his wife was. Solomon was too busy with too many wives. Was untrustworthy because he was an employee of the IRS. Mark was a deserter. Peter acted too much like a gang member. And Paul was too busy murdering Christians. But man needed help. So Jesus took himself the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of men. And then found in a fashion that man humbled himself and became obedient even to the death of the cross. And one Friday he died. He knew we needed help. So he died. They put him in the grave. Stayed there all night Friday. All day Saturday. All night Saturday night. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. Provided us the help we need. He knew we needed help. And now we know where to look when we need help. Look to Jesus, the Lamb of God. Jesus, the rose of Sharon and the lily of the valley. Jesus, the chiefest among 10,000. Jesus, the bright and morning star. Jesus, the captain of our salvation. Jesus, the living bread. Jesus, the living water. Jesus, the only begotten of the Father.
Yes,
Jesus, the living stone.
Yes.
Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the Ancient of Days. He is the beloved Son of God. But most of all, he is my help. To look to for help. Where do you look for help? Who do you turn to
keep you.
Yeah.
He is willing to aid you. Jesus will carry you through. You just gotta ask him, get on your knees, and ask him to help you, and he will comfort you. He will keep you. He will hold you in his arms and give you the help you need. Call him in the morning. Call him at noon. Call him in the midnight hour. He will. He will. He will. Come to your rescue. He will. Where to look?
Oh, yes, he will.
When you need help.
Yeah, yeah.
Look to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. Look to Jesus. He will carry you. God bless you.
Shall we bow our heads, Lord? We thank you for this candidate today.
Yes.
And we ask, Lord, that you build a hedge around him.
Please, Lord.
We know Satan's really going to get busy now.
Yes, yes.
But we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Good morning, Mount Olive. We have Brother Jorge Santiago. He's been to this area from Brooklyn, New York. He gave his life to Christ last week and then glad to be baptized today. New members class this morning.
Amen. Amen.
Okay, based on the profession of your faith in Christ Jesus and obedience to the great head of the church, I now baptize in the name of the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
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 Shall we stand with you? The grace of our Lord, the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, rest, rule, and abide with us until we meet again, and then, Lord, we ask that you give us traveling grace from here to Munson. And then, Lord, if it's thy will, give us traveling grace back from Munson, back to Richmond. In Jesus' name we pray. Let the whole house say,
Amen.